and Cats Dust Countdown. Sean Locke, Joe Wilkinson, Kevin Bridges, Victoria Corin Mitchell, Adam Kay, Susie Dent, and Rachel Riley. And your host, Jimmy Carr.
Hello, and welcome to Editor 10 Cats Dust Countdown, a show all about letters, numbers, and conundrums. Right, let's meet tonight's players. First up is Sean Locke. Sean doesn't use social media. He prefers to keep up with what his friends are doing using good old-fashioned surveillance. And joining Sean tonight is Kevin Bridges. Kevin is from Glasgow, a place synonymous with anger, heavy drinking and the constant threat of violence. So to make him feel at home, we've put him next to Sean. OK, up against them this evening, it's guest team captain Joe Wilkinson. Joe Wilkinson is an animal lover, and I mean that literally. And Joe's teammate, Victoria Corin Mitchell. Victoria hosts the esoteric quiz show Only Connect, and if you don't know what esoteric means, then stick with us, it's not for you. Sure, what's the riskiest thing you've ever done?
Well, you know, in Forrest Gump, he said, life is like a box of chocolates, didn't he?
He did, yeah.
It's more like a box of tissues. Just tossing, just living dangerously, throwing the years away, living in wild abandon. My first job, I milked snakes for their venom. Everyone else had paper rounds. I was on the subs bench for a trapeze act. You're sitting there, you're thinking, they're fine, I can relax, have a can. And then you hear this blood-curdling scream and the sound of bones hitting the floor, and you think, shit, I'm on. And then I live dangerously. The other day I bought a mattress on eBay.
Joe, if you could go back to any period in time, Joe, where would you go?
I had a pretty good Wednesday. Because the corner shop started selling out-of-date turkey mince for a quid. I love a bargain, Jimmy. I love a bargain. Even though it did give me the runs. But,
I suppose what you saved on the turkey mince, you spent on toilet paper.
Yeah.
Joe doesn't strike me as the kind of guy that buys toilet paper.
I've got a fun fact for you. The average person spends £180 a year on toilet roll. So, if you think about it, if you hadn't wiped your ass in 2017, you could now buy some new patio furniture.
Kevin, now, who's the most famous person you've ever met?
Barack Obama. There we go. That's true.
So how did you meet? How did your paths cross?
I was asked to perform for Obama. They phoned me up. Barack Obama's in Scotland, Kev. He needs a chuckle. I'm the guy to draft in. I met Nicole Scherzinger recently. You know, the pussycat doll? Don't you, huh?
You know what I'm That's, yeah, don't you, lady, yeah.
And I never knew. It was just me and her in the room for like a couple of minutes, and I thought I better say something. And football is always a good icebreaker.
With any of the pussycat dolls. Yes.
Just told her that I'm a Celtic fan, and we used to have a South Korean right back called Cha Do Ri, and we used to sing, "Don't you wish your right back was Cha Do Ri?" And she never laughed. She just sort of. She just picked up her phone and started texting. Who the fuck am I being left alone with?
I was once in the library at college with a friend of mine, and he was reading the sports pages of the paper, and he started chuckling. And I said, "Oh, what's making you laugh?" And he went, "How many people in this South African football team do you think are called Hitler?" There was someone in the South African football team called Hitler?
Well, it's not Hitler's fault. He's really good at football. I mean, I still love watching some of Hitler's goals. I'm sorry. He was a bloody acrobat. He's a dreadful human being. But an amazing... Trying to think up a position there.
You've got to be right wing, isn't it?
Right wing back, yeah.
OK, Victoria, you're a professional poker player, as well as everything else, but you play poker to a very high standard. What's the most extravagant thing you've ever bought with your winnings?
The first time I won a big tournament, I paid off my mortgage and I got a new kitchen. And I proudly told people that. I said, oh, I've paid off my mortgage with this and I've got a new kitchen. And everyone else in the game said, that's why women shouldn't be allowed to play poker. So the next time I won a tournament, Jimmy, I spent it all on hookers and blow.
When you win money in poker, do you need to pay tax? Just asking for a friend.
Joe, I presume you don't have a mascot. Do you have a mascot?
I have, Jimmy. I've got, got something very dear to me. I've got this oven mitt. My mum got it for me when she went to Tenerife. And I love it, cos... You probably won't know this, but this means I love New York.
Fuck!
Because the heart means love. That blew me away, that. I thought we should do more of these. You should do it with other towns, but using other organs from the body to mean other things. So I've mocked up a few, like... Like, this one is I kidney Sutton Coldfield. In this case, kidney means am ambivalent about. I've never been there, so I don't know if it's nice. And this one is I small intestines Lyme Regis. In this case, small intestines means have had my trousers and pants pulled down outside Robert Dyer's Inn. And this last one, simply, I rectum Huddersfield. That's what it says on the can, that one, so, yeah. So, imagine those on an oven mitt. Ooh! Squids in, I won't have to do this shit anymore.
Joe Wilkinson, everyone.
Kevin, have you got a mascot?
That's quite creepy. I'm all just wanted it out of my house. It's myself. Can you see that there? It's like me. I was in an Asda before, promoting my book there, and they asked if I'd stand inside a 3D printer, and then they would print off this wee creep. And it's been lying in my house for 3 or 4 years, and I actually lost a foot. On the way here, I was flying here, and my bag beeped, and the maid pulled. I had to put this on the tray table, and then I put it on the table, and then the guy looked at it, and then he looked at me, and he's like, he thought I was a egomaniac. Like, I carry a porcelain 6-inch doll of myself everywhere I go. Maybe put it on their side to kind of get in their heads a bit. It's a bit intimidating, isn't it? Get it facing them.
I don't mind that. Going off it a little bit.
Nice.
Do you ever play with it when you're drunk? Like, set up a stage and it's the Oscars, and then you go, I'm the winner of Best Actor Oscar is Kevin Bridges. Sorry about that.
That's all right, I was footless.
Victoria, have you got a mascot?
Yes. I brought this, which is a packet that some apples came in from the supermarket. See, it's from a mystery shop. But I brought another one as well, which is from another mystery shop. What it is that this packet, it says on the back, plastic not currently recycled. Right, this is what I don't understand. You can get plastic packets that can be recycled. Here's one, balloons came in that. Balloons. Apples don't need to come in a packet at all. I don't mind, I'll have it in a paper bag. It could just be loose, I'm gonna wash it anyway. But here comes this thing. If you can get packets that can be recycled, why isn't all packaging made out of it? Like when people say, why isn't the whole plane made out of the thing that the black box recorder is made out of? But, no, they've decided that some of their packaging can't be recycled. So my question is, what am I meant to do with it? I can't recycle it. If I put it in the bin, I might as well be personally strangling a seagull. So, do I keep it? I mean, that's weird. That's like the first step in being one of those people that keeps their own wee in a test tube. I don't want to keep my own wee. It's not hygienic. So, these packets just accrue. So I brought them here. Now it's your problem.
Well, I mean... Sean, have you got a mascot?
No, I'm sorry. Didn't come through this week.
What's that behind you, then?
No, that... I did ask for a gong.
Is that not a mascot?
It was going to be a mascot. It's the wrong gong. You know, a lot of people at the end of the game, when the clock goes...
Yeah.
..they carry on. And I thought, that's a good way to stop it. So he goes, do-do-do-do-do-do-do, boo! And then I thought, if I hit the gong, everyone will stop. But that tune is in D. And this bloody thing is in C. So it basically renders this useless.
Yeah, it doesn't work, does it? I think if you're going to hit it, I think shirt off.
No, that's what a lot of us gongists really resent about the pigeonholing of gongists. That we're stripped to the waist with a bit of loincloth. We're not all like that. Some of us are artists. You know, people think you just hit it. But there's a lot more to it than that. You've got to find the plum spot. I think you can see where it's more dented there. That's the plum spot. I've been having lessons with the principal gongist from the LSO.
Oh, what's...?
The Luton Symphony Orchestra. Thank you, Em.
What's he called, Sean?
I never catch his name. but it's a great instrument. There isn't a song in the world that isn't improved by this beauty. Just play something, anything.
It's better, yeah.
It's better.
Sean Lock, everyone. Well, over in Dictionary Corner, it's Adam Kay. Adam is a doctor who's written a hilarious book about working as an NHS gynecologist. It offers a real peek behind the curtains. Adam, you're a doctor. A quick question. Putting a Henry the Hoover up your bum and sitting on the washing machine during a spin cycle, bad for you or not? I'm asking for a friend.
That's known as a brown wash. And it's less dangerous than you'd think.
Now, Adam, you've written this book about being an NHS doctor. Tell me about it.
So, I did used to be a doctor, and I would write down all the weird shit that happened to me. Here's a diary entry from 16th of September 2005. After a lengthy discussion with a patient about how absolutely no condoms fit him, I establish he's pulling them right down over his balls.
And with Adam, of course, it's Susie Dent. Over the years, Susie Dent has really made that seat her own, because now it vibrates. Susie, now we've got a doctor on the show this evening, and Adam Kay. Are there any interesting medical words you could tell us about?
Well, I've got questions for Adam because in a book I wrote, I met quite a lot of doctors and looked at their, like, tribal talk. Do you talk about a patient who has CBT in a different sort of sense, chronic biscuit toxicity?
Yes.
OK, so that's for someone who's really fat.
It is. It's important to talk in code so they don't understand you. Like, if a patient's just sort of running out of steam and they're a bit old and decrepit, the diagnosis you'd write in the notes would be TMB for too many birthdays.
Oh. It's an actual doctor. And in charge of the numbers, it's Rachel Riley. Rachel, you're learning Russian at the moment. How's that going?
Yeah, it's good. Still going well. I'm still learning. And there are a lot of words that in English sound really rude, but obviously they're completely innocent in Russian. So if you want to say it's not true, they literally say it's not a fact. Knee fucked.
That's also a medical term as well. You go to the doctor and you walk in with a limp and you go, knee fucked.
OK, the prize the teams will be competing for tonight is this, the Countdown Microwave. Letters, and I think if I was doing this, I would say, Victoria, you get the pick of the letters. Joe, just, you know,
see if I can write them down.
consonant, please.
Thank you, Victoria. T.
Vowel, please.
A.
Consonant, please.
L.
Consonant, please.
Come on, another L.
R.
Vowel, please.
U.
Ooh. Vowel.
I.
Consonant, please.
W.
This is awful.
It's not great.
Consonant, please.
How do you know it's rubbish?
G.
Oh. Start again.
Vowel, please.
E. Everything's fine.
OK, and for the first time today, here's the countdown clock. Come on. Another 30 seconds, I would have had him. Had him right where I wanted him. Joe, how many letters?
Got a risky 3.
Victoria, how many?
That was genuinely distracting. Mm. I think 6.
OK, Kevin?
6.
Sean?
6.
We all got 6 in.
Well, no, because you got 3. Unless you want to do your 3 twice.
Wig, wig.
Victoria, what is your 6?
Waiter.
Waiter. What's your 6, Kevin?
I've also got that.
Sean, your 6?
Retail.
Dictionary Corner, Adam, Susie, could they have done any better?
So there's an 8, which is ligature, which is a bit medical.
Ooh.
And 6 glutei, as in the plural of arses.
So at the end of that, both teams have 6 points. OK, on to our first numbers round. Sean, Kevin, your turn to pick the numbers.
I'll have a usual.
The Sean regular. 2 large and 4 little. Right, we've got 7, 5,
oh, slow down.
4, 8, and the big ones, 50 and 25.
Oh, God.
And the target, 195.
OK, your time starts now. Do your maths.
Thank you.
OK, your target was 195. Did you get it, Sean? Kevin?
Yeah, I've got it.
You got it. Victoria?
Yes.
OK, Joe?
Is this one of those ones that's really obvious?
It's quite easy.
Oh, shit! Is it really an easy one?
How about if I just go like this?
Oh, fuck!
What do you think, Joe? Because this could still be wrong.
All right, 50 times the 5.
Yeah.
I'm going to need them other numbers.
I've got 250.
Can I have a look at yours?
Yeah.
25 times 8, that's incredible. Minus the 5. 25 times 8 minus
25
the 5.
25 times 8, 200 minus the 5. Well done.
Oh, cheers.
Sean, Alan. Kevin, how did you do it?
7 times 25.
725 is
175. And then 4 times 5 is 20.
Yeah.
10 points for both teams.
Yeah. 10 points.
OK, the scores at the moment. Everyone's got 16 points, neck and neck. And here is your teaser. The words are a swinger. The clue is how very dare you. That's a swinger. How very dare you. See you after the break. The answer to the teaser, the words were a swinger. The clue was, how very dare you. It was, of course, swearing. OK, they've been playing in teams so far, but this game is just for Sean and Joe.
Brilliant.
So, Sean, you get to choose the letters and also win.
Brilliant. Vowel, please.
Thanks, Sean. Oh.
Consonant, please.
Deep.
Vowel.
A.
Consonant.
N.
Consonant.
T.
Consonant.
S.
Vowel.
I.
Another consonant.
N.
Consonant, please.
P.
OK. And your time starts now. Joe, what do you think? What? Okay. Joe, how many you got?
5.
Sean?
6. Jimmy?
You've got a 6. OK, what's your 5?
Pints.
Pints.
There's an O there, Joe.
Oh, cock and balls.
Sean?
Depots.
Depots.
Oh.
As in,
is that an E?
That's the E.
Oh.
So, Sean, talk me through how you're feeling at the moment.
Yeah, I'm processing it.
It feels to me like you were so confident, you had it all, and then that beat you.
Yeah. Keep your own, love. Got pints.
Well, it's a fairy tale story for you, Joe.
Should we go home?
Well, incredibly, I never thought I'd say it. 5 points to Joe! Adam, Susie, I mean, how much better could they have done?
You could have had Sandpit for 7.
So at the end of that, Sean and Kevin have 16, Joe and Victoria have 21. Because Joe won the points. Right, now time for Victoria and Kevin to go head-to-head. Victoria, your turn to pick the numbers.
Oh, dear. Maybe one big number and the rest small, please.
Good choice. One big, five little, and this time you have 7, 8, 8, 2, 5, and 25. And the target, 827.
OK, and your time starts now. OK, the target was 827. Victoria, what did you get?
835.
That'll do.
It won't.
835 might do. We'll see. Kevin, what did you get?
Can you come back to me? In a minute. I've got nothing. Ooh. At all.
Nothing?
I'll just make up a sum to try and get close. 8 times 8 is 64. Is that right?
If you want.
Yeah, I'll try and wing something.
Sure. All right.
Times...
Divide it by 2.
Divide it by 2. Sorry, I've...
Times 25. 25.
Times 25. Go for that.
800.
Yes. And what have we got left?
A 7.
Fuck. add 7. You sure we've got nothing
only 20
left?
20 away.
Okay, you get nothing for that.
I will.
Okay, how did you get 835, Victoria?
Well, I mean, this might not be right, but I think 8 and 8 is 16.
Yeah.
Times 25 is 400.
Yeah.
Times 2 is 800.
Yeah.
And that leaves a 7 and a 5, so 7 times 5 and added on, and I think you get 835.
You do? Yeah. Well,
well done.
So you get 8 away, you get 5 points for that. Okay. Yeah. Rachel Riley, and I'll be disappointed if you say it can't be done. Can it be done?
Yeah, it can. This was actually surprisingly close. If you say 8 times 25 is 200, add the 5 for 205. And then the other 8 divided by 2 is 4. Times them together for 820, another 7.
Jesus Christ.
That's really hard.
Yeah. OK, time now to go across to Dictionary Corner. Adam, what have you got for us?
I've got some of my medical diaries. So when I was a doctor, I used to work in the field of obstetrics and gynaecology, or brats and twats. and this... is an entry from the 12th of March 2005. Prescribing a morning after pill in A&E, the patient asks me, I slept with 3 guys last night. Will one pill be enough? And Joe, the answer is yes. of November 2005, first patient of gynaecology clinic. I'm writing a letter to the GP and need to use the phrase pussy discharge, but I don't know how to spell it without getting struck off. 12th of January 2006. 3 a.m. attendance at Labour Ward triage. The patient is 25 years old and 30 weeks into her first pregnancy. She complains of a large number of painless spots on her tongue. Diagnosis: taste buds. Huh. 5th of September 2007. I noticed that every patient on the ward has a pulse of 60 beats per minute recorded in their chart, so I subtly inspect the healthcare assistant's measurement technique. He feels the patient's pulse, looks at his watch, and meticulously counts the number of seconds per minute.
The scores at the moment, Sean and Kevin are on 16, Joe and Victoria are on 26. And here is your teaser. The words are Joe cried. The clue is, it made me happy. That's Joe cried, it made me happy. See you after the break.
Welcome back. The answer to the teaser. The words were, Joe cried. The clue was, it made me happy. It was, of course, rejoiced. OK, before we get on with the game, time for a quick bonus round. Now, Victoria hosts Only Connect, the smartest quiz on TV. But this is Cat's Countdown. So, once again, we're going to test our teams with the stupidest quiz on television. OK, here is your first question in the stupidest quiz on television. Which of these is not the name of a real politician? Is it A, Young Boozer? B, Butch Otter? C, Lance Thrust? D, Dick Sweat? E, Lady Garden? Or F, Tiny Cox? Which of those is not real? Five of them are real, one of them isn't real.
There's some stupid names in the UK politics. Oh, yeah. Eric Pickles, isn't it? Ed Balls. Vince Cable. Fucking, that's a superhero name, isn't it?
It really is. And when you look at him, not so much. We're going to need an answer from both teams.
We're going to go with Lady Garden.
Which one are you going
Butch
for?
Butch Otter.
You're going for Butch Otter. Well, I can tell you that Young Boozer is the state treasurer of Alabama. Dick Sweat is the former Democratic congressman. Here he is with Hillary Clinton. Tiny Cox is a Dutch politician.
He's married, though. He's got a ring on his finger. Yep. Wonder what his wife's called. Easily pleased.
Butch Otter is, I'm afraid to say, the governor of Idaho.
Ah, we're still in it.
Ooh. Yeah. Lady Garden is a Lib Dem peer. Oh. I can tell you the answer is Lance Thrust.
Oh, easy.
OK, next stupid question. Which of these is taller, Victoria Coren Mitchell or 41 Victoria Sponge Cakes? Obviously, Victoria's at a huge advantage here because she knows how big she is.
How tall are you, Victoria?
Would I reveal that information?
Very clever. You are now part of MI5.
OK, we need to get a quick answer here because the cakes are collapsing fast. That's what someone's doing. A professional's just said that in my ear. OK, so what are you going to go for, cakes or Victoria?
Cakes.
Whatever
cakes.
You want. Whatever you want.
OK,
bring on the cakes. Let's find out.
Oh, my God, I'm not smaller than that.
Victoria, if you'd like to stand next to the sponges.
The cakes are on tippy-toe.
Oh.
Yes! I think we will need shoes off.
Oh! Did you say that?
Well, it's got to be a shoes-off affair, hasn't it? Wow!
Yes!
I think Victoria Coren Mitchell is taller than 41 yes. Victoria Sponges. Oh, you get the point. Yes. Congratulations, Victoria. Yeah. Congratulations. Have you got any words you'd like to say? Anything you'd like to...
No, I always thought I was short, but then they never measured it in cakes before. Oh, that's really nice. Can I take one?
Yeah, sure. You can have 41 of them if you want.
This is brilliant. This is the best episode I've ever done.
Victoria Coren Mitchell. Taller than 41 Victoria Sponges. OK, next stupid question. Time to test your wildlife knowledge. Which of these has the widest wingspan? A Eurasian eagle owl or Rachel Riley? What do you think? What's got the largest wingspan?
Are we talking about a fully grown Rachel Riley?
Yeah. A mature one.
Mature one.
Mature one, yeah.
How tall are you, Rachel?
I can tell you that Rachel is... she's about 47 Victoria Sponges.
You say that is your height supposed to be? Putting your wingspan is supposed to be the same as your height?
Apart from Mr. Tickle.
And that's from a doctor.
I can't remember the last time that I seen a Eurasian eagle owl. I think it's going to be Rachel. I would
You're
go
going
for
Rachel, what
here.
Are you going to go for?
Big owl.
Big owl. Well, let's find out. Bring on the owl. Just be quiet, everyone in the studio. That is a live owl. We've done that with hairspray.
Where did you get this?
Where did we get it? Jumble sale. We definitely thought of the question before we got the prop, by the way.
I don't know.
It's very, very close, but it's Rachel Riley has the biggest wingspan. Congratulations, Rachel.
I'm just saying the ones I know are bigger.
OK. Well, that's the end of the stupidest quiz on television, and I can tell you it's a draw. 5 points to both teams. I OK, on with the game. Joe and Victoria, your turn to choose the letters.
Could I have a consonant, please?
Thanks, Joe. R.
A vowel.
E.
We'll try and spell a word, it's the only one I can do it. A consonant.
G.
Vowel.
U.
Consonant.
S.
Consonant.
T.
Vowel.
A.
Consonant.
V.
And a consonant, please.
And an S.
OK, and your time starts now. Start at the bottom. Joe, how many letters?
I've got five.
Pretty good. Pretty good. Victoria?
Seven.
Sean, how many?
Six.
Six. And Kevin?
Seven.
Joe, you go first because yours was worst.
Gusts.
Gusts.
Yeah, or rave.
Sean, you're six?
Surges.
So just Victoria, what was your seven?
Gravest.
Gravest.
Nice. Most grave.
Very nice.
Most grave.
Very nice.
Kevin, your seven?
Vaguest.
Nice.
Oh, nice.
Very good.
Nice. Is that there? Yeah. I was kind of doubting myself a bit.
Yeah, very good.
To be the most vague.
Yeah.
7 points to Victoria and Kevin. Very well done. Could they? And, you know, they got sevens, but could they have done any better?
They could have got one of these eights where you're like, oh, yeah, I'd have never guessed that. So it's sevrugas, which are the fishes that produce the sevruga caviar.
Sevrugas?
Yes.
Right. The scores at the moment, Sean and Kevin have 28, Joe and Victoria have 38. Yeah. OK, time to go once again to Victory Corner. Adam, can we have some more entries from your diary?
You can indeed. 29th of February, 2008. Special occasions call for patients to insert special types of objects into their vaginas and recta. Christmas in particular has rewarded me well with a stuck fairy, a swollen vulva from a mistletoe contact allergy, and vaginal burns from a patient stuffing a string of lights inside and turning them on. Bringing new meaning to the phrase, I put the Christmas lights up for myself. This is my first leap year working as a doctor, and the great British public have really pulled it out of the bag for me with a very, very specific injury. Patient JB decided to take advantage of tradition and proposed to her boyfriend, going to the expense of buying an engagement ring, the trouble of putting it inside a Kinder Surprise egg, and the imagination of inserting it vaginally. Her partner would discover it, retrieve it, and then she would go down on one knee. Unfortunately, he was unable to retrieve it as planned. It had rotated itself lengthwise, and no amount of sugarling from either of them would get this particular goose to lay its golden egg. Remarkably, she was so keen to maintain the surprise, she wouldn't tell him what she'd done or why, but eventually decided it was a hospital matter, so we met in cubicle three. It was a very easy delivery with a pair of forceps. She hadn't told me about the contents of the egg either at this point, so there was a moment of confusion for both me and the boyfriend when she asked him to open it. I gave him a pair of latex gloves, sandblasting the last trace of romance from the scenario. She popped the question, and he said yes, presumably out of fear as to what a woman who does that with a Kinder Surprise would do to him if spurned.
I think that story deserves.
Is that true?
Yes.
Somebody thought a nice way to get engaged was to put an engagement ring in their minge.
Someone was right. Here is your final teaser. The words are bare bods, and the clue is soak it all in. That's bare bods, soak it all in. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser. The words were bare bods. The clue was soak it all in. It was, of course, absorbed. OK, time for our final letters game. Sean and Kevin, your turn to choose the letters.
Off you go.
A vowel, please, Rachel.
Thank you, Kevin.
And then three consonants.
C, L and B.
Vowel, please.
E.
And then another vowel. The rest.
I.
The rest in consonants.
And S, R and T.
OK, your 30 seconds starts now. What? Pip. Oh, no. Sean, how many?
Eight.
Kevin?
Six.
Joe?
Five. Confident five.
Victoria?
Eight.
OK. What's your five?
Loser.
You are?
I'm winning, mate.
What's your six, Kevin?
Strobe.
Sean, you're eight?
Cloister.
Very good.
What? I will be in the cloister later to arrange everything.
Victoria.
I had a cloister as well. There it is. Cloister.
For fuck's sake.
Okay, it's 8 points for both teams. Fair enough. Okay. Adam, Susie, could they have done any better?
No, they could have got other eights, such as costlier and quartiles, just eights.
OK, so Sean and Kevin have 36, Joe and Victoria have 46.
Yes. Ooh.
That means this is a crucial countdown conundrum. If you get this, you can draw.
Oh.
All right, fingers on buzzers. Your time starts now.
Oh, no, that's not right.
Why did you make me press it, then?
Sorry.
No, OK, let's restart the clock. False alarm. Sean.
I think I got it.
Sean?
Oh.
Please don't get it.
Well, I was going to say this word, which I think you'll find.
I'm going to restart the clock. Now, you're going to have to press the button pretty much immediately. OK, restarting the clock now.
Oh!
I will allow it. What is the word?
No.
What? I haven't heard a gong, Sean. I haven't heard a gong. Joe, what's the word? Quick.
I thought... No, I got it wrong.
Didn't you think it was?
I thought it might be panelist. But there's loads of E's.
No, this is going to have to go to penalties.
This is really difficult. I thought it was plainest, but there's too many E's for that as
they
well.
Still don't have it. I said the word and they still don't have it. That's the level we're playing at here. I can say the word and they still go, well, I don't know.
Is it penalties, Jimmy?
Yeah.
Is there any way you could edit it so I do that and then you ask me and then I say, is it penalties?
Sure. Joe, what is it?
Penalties.
So, the final scores are Sean and Kevin have 36 points, but tonight's winners, with 46 points, Joe and Victoria! Congratulations, you're now the proud owners of this, the Countdown Microwave! Thanks to all our panelists, our wonderful studio audience, and all of you watching at home. That's it from us. Good night!
Mark Wahlberg is pumped and ready to steal in Pain and Gain, the network premiere tomorrow at 10. Coming up, Eye Before You Buy, and this series has a naked attraction first. It's new. Join Anna Richardson next.